BassMint by Unfiltered Audio is a bass enhancement plugin to bring out the bass presence of your audio, so it can improve your low end from this to this. I'm going to show you how it sounds and how it works. I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. The plugin is a deceivingly simple looking plugin. 5 modes, 5 rotating knobs, and 6 options. To show you how it sounds, we need to get over the knobs, buttons, and dials. And since this is all about that bass, no treble, I recommend you use good headphones or speakers to listen to the rest of this video. The main bulk of the work is done with the 5 rotators in the center. Let's use the saturate mode to show what the 5 dials do. And later in the video, the 4 other modes will be explored. Saturate will send the bass below the cutoff frequency through saturation and extra harmonics will be created. This mode is usable for bringing out the low end on smaller speakers like phones. Okay, the dials. The cutoff sends which parts of the audio below the cutoff frequency you set here is used for the bass enhancement. Strength sets how much of the boost is mixed in. Soften uses another low-pass filter to smoothen the edges of the bass signal. With saturate, you'll notice the low end gets less boomy and is more focused to the sub-lows. Shelf is a low shelf cut or boost, which uses about the same frequency to what you have set with the cutoff dial and can be used to fine-tune the low-end enhancement even more. Clarity removes mud around 400 Hz and boosts treble and high-end presence. That sounds by itself like a nice drum EQ dial. Take a close look at this frequency graph. The 400 Hz dip can get pretty severe. Now, to the left are 5 modes, 5 different algorithms on how you can do the bass enhancing. From top to bottom, you see saturate, resonate, octave, synthesize, and overfold. And the 5 dials to the right all work slightly different with each mode. We already checked how saturate sounds, so resonate is next. Resonate is a very resonant high-pass filter where the cutoff is obviously the cutoff frequency. And the strength knob is for the resonance of the filter. Now, as you can hear, this isn't that great on an entire mix, but way better suited for individual tracks. The manual states it emulates the voice of God mixing effect, which is basically the very resonant high pass on a voice. And if you increase it, it will sound like this. This is called the voice of God effect. Next up is the octave effect. This will take the audio below the cutoff filter and pitch it up an octave. So this one can also help you to make the low end of the mix sound more clear on smaller devices and will help you to give bass heavy instruments more lower mid-range. To make the octave boost more clear, let me show you that with this sinus wave. This is without the octave boost. And when I increase the strength, you'll see the harmonics will increase too. With soften, you can roll off the added harmonics. Synthesize is basically a subharmonic sine wave, which envelope is determined by an envelope follower. You set the frequency of that subsynth here. This one is ideal for kick drums since it's a fixed frequency which will be added. It's not really suited for melodic material. With kick drums, just set a frequency which will fit the bass drum and the music. Now, since this frequency is automatable, you can let it follow the chord changes in music, which is very handy in EDM. Now, the final one is Overfold, which is basically the saturate mode on steroids. It's not so subtle and mostly useful when the normal saturation doesn't do the trick or you want to do sound design or a very obvious effect. The six toggles on the right are very handy when you want to fine-tune your bass enhancing. The anti-rumble is a high-pass filter which filters everything out below 30 Hz, so you can avoid hectic compressor or limiter behavior. Mid only applies the bass enhancing to only the mid of the mid-side signal. Since bass and especially sub-bass is largely mono by nature, this will make sure you don't run into issues on, for instance, stereo to mono conversions or when you need to work on masters for vinyl. Solo bass is only the bass below the cutoff. That is nice for monitoring the low end with the enhancement, or use this on a separate duplicate track to mix it in, parallel processing wise. The mono toggle will make all bass below the cutoff mono. Soft clip will enable soft clipping of the plugin to avoid hard sounding hard clipping. And the bypass does bypassing. There's a randomized button here if you need inspiration for sound design and such. And you can customize the plugin too. You can choose from 4 color settings. You can set how much randomizing you want when using the randomize button. You can enable or disable the frequency display. And you can enable tooltips. For me, this plugin is a nice addition to the bass enhancement plugins I already own, like the Leapwing Audio Root 1 or the BX Subsynth. The major plus points of this plugin for me are the 5 modes, which makes this plugin very versatile. It offers more than just simple bass enhancement. I'm curious to find out how this plugin holds up against other bass enhancement plugins. And if you are too, you must see the video displayed on screen right now. Please remember to subscribe and share this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!